An update to plans for Artemis, the next space station crew transport mission, and collaboration in the interest of space. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. We published our Artemis plan to land the first woman and the next man on the moon in 2024. The plan includes details about a new test during the Artemis 2 mission in 2023, when astronauts will manually fly the Orion spacecraft to see how it handles in space. NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine discussed the agency's plans and budget during a U.S. Senate appropriations hearing on September 23rd.
The budget that we have before the House and the Senate today is a very strong budget. And I think it is a budget that ultimately enables us to continue to push forward humanity into the solar system in a way that we've never done before.
The first Artemis mission without astronauts, Artemis 1, is on track for 2021. Learn more at nasa.gov/Artemis. The International Space Station's next crew, including NASA's Kate Rubins, wrapped up training in Star City, Russia. Rubins and Russian crewmates Sergei Ryzhikov and Sergei Kutsverchkov are set to launch October 14th from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. A new Memorandum of Understanding announced September 22nd by NASA and the U.S. Space Force calls for collaboration between the organizations in a broad range of areas including human spaceflight, U.S. space policy, space transportation, standards and best practices for safe operations in space, scientific research, and planetary defense. NASA's OSIRISRex spacecraft has spotted pieces of asteroid Vesta that are somehow on Bennu, the asteroid from which OREX will attempt to collect a sample in late October. It's believed that the material came from Bennu's parent asteroid after a fragment from Vesta struck the parent. This sheds light on the violent origin of Bennu, which is an asteroid that formed from fragments of a massive collision. Data from NASA instruments on the European Space Agency's Rosetta mission have helped reveal that comet 67P Churyumov-Gerasimenko has its own far ultraviolet aurora. It is the first time such electromagnetic emissions in the far ultraviolet have been documented on a celestial object other than a planet or moon. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.